Hi students, good morning everybody. Now we will learn today about the third lesson, that is nothing but a animal fiber. Okay, in your previous class, that is in your sixth class, you completed about the fabric, fiber to fabric. Okay, what do you learn in fiber to fabric lesson in your sixth class? Okay, what do you learn once you recollect it? That is connected to this lesson now, animal fiber. Okay, here in this lesson we are interested in learning about the life story of silkworm. Okay, today we will see about complete life story of silkworm and how the silk is extracted from the silkworm and how the cloths are made up of. Okay, these things we will learn in this session. Okay, now come back to the our lesson is the animal fiber. Come on, tell me the few examples of plants which give the fiber. Come on, name it. Okay, I see now. See here, examples are jute. Do you know the jute? And cotton, big sorrel leaves, gomura. Okay, jute, cotton, sorrel leaf. Nowadays recently they are researching on the aloe vera, the extracting the threads from the aloe vera and preparing the cells. Here these are the examples of the plants which give fiber. Not only these, they are doing experiments on other plants too. Another one is that here, bamboo. Do you know the bamboo? Yes, bamboo stick also they are using. So these are the various examples that the plants gives the fiber. Now say few more examples that animals which give the fiber. Do you know animals which give the fiber? Okay, here sheep, goat, camel, silkworm. Next, llama, alpaca. These are the various examples that animals give the fiber. In this lesson, we are going to learn about the animals which give the fiber. In your previous sixth class, you learned about the plants which give the fiber. In your seventh class, now you are going to learn about the animal fiber, animals which give the fiber, especially two animals. That is a silkworm, another one is a sheep. Okay, one is a silkworm and another one is a sheep. Okay, in this session, you are going to learn about the silkworm, story of silkworm. Okay, let us start now. Good. Okay, you have to note down the important points too from this. It's very important lesson. Okay, now comes to the point. First one is a sericulture. What do you mean by sericulture? Sericulture is nothing but rearing of silkworm. Rearing of silkworm. Silkworm ni penchukovatam. Understood? Okay, that means here, same like our agriculture, here also we will call the person who will rear the silkworms are known as farmers. Manam agriculture lo farmers ani pilustuntam kada. See, in this case also, silkworm ni evaraithe grow chestunaro, we will call them as a farmers. Okay, now here sericulture, rearing of silkworm, the people, farmers who grows the silkworms are known as, the process is known as sericulture. That is sericulture. Ani cheptam rearing, growing, penchukovadam silkworms ni. Okay, now the scientific name of the silkworm is Bombyx mori. What is scientific name of the silkworm? Is a Bombyx mori. That is why it is scientific name. That means suppose in our country we will call it as some other name. In America they will call it as some other name. In But scientifically, all over the world, they will call it as a Bombyx mori. Okay, Bombyx mori. Okay, this is the scientific name of the silkworm. Very, very important that remember, pronounce it properly. Bombyx mori. Okay. Now, come to the point of that story of silk. Now, story of silk will start now. Okay. It's consisting of a 4 stars. How many stars? In the story of a silk, four stars are there. Star 1, star 2, star 3, star 4. There are 4 stars are there. That means here in your textbook they are mentioning in the way of story. Okay, that means they said that one of the girl name is Neelima. Okay, that means this girl Neelima is based in the sericulture industry, and as she visits various places, she will explain as it's her experience. Okay, that means this Neelima is sharing the experience with us by explaining the story of the silkworm. So she is saying that there are 4 stars are there, and she is visiting the star 1. Now, in the star 1 is nothing but a moth to egg. What do you mean by moth? Moth is a silkworm. The adult silkworm is known as a moth, which will have the wings. And they can be seen like a butterfly. But butterfly has the colorful wings, whereas these has a plain wings. Okay. Not as much as size of the butterfly. Butterfly is the short la chinna. So that is known as a moth. Moth. Okay? Moth to egg. In star 1. In star 1 we will learn moth to egg. Okay? Now see here. They are saying that the eggs of the silk moth is known as seeds. Eggs of the silk moth is known as seeds. Why we will call it as a seeds? Tell me. Do you know the seeds? How it will be? Take mustard seeds along with very small, 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 small size. Am I right? Take some other seeds which will be very small size. So we will call it as a seeds. Because what the point now? These eggs are very small in size, just like our mustard seeds. Our the size only untai avi. So scientists, they kept the name as a seeds for this. So eggs of the silk moth is known as a seeds. Now see here, what is the color of these seeds? Sometimes ash color, sometimes white and creamy color. Their ash color are sometimes are white or creamy color, but very, very, very small in size. Okay. They will take the food as a mulberry leaf. Do you know the meaning of mulberry leaves? You know very well these leaves, but you don't know that it is called as a mulberry leaf. Tuturpallu. Got it? Tuturpallu. Black color, red color. Black color, sweet color, tuturpallu. Got it? That is mulberry leaf. Okay. This tuturpallu is known as a mulberry leaves. So, what is the food of the silkworm? It's a mulberry leaf. Okay. Who wants to grow this? Silkworms, definitely they should have the feed of mulberry plants. Because they have to feed these silkworms with a mulberry leaves. Okay. Okay. She is visiting some of the places and she is introducing herself to the other people, the people who are working in a sericulture industries, and she is conversing with that. So now here the adult silkworm, it will stop feeding and settle in one place. okay? It will die after laying the 500 eggs. It will die. Now, see here. Nilima is visiting the various places. See here. Nilima is visiting the various places like Chittoor district, Anantapur, Chittoor. She is asking different names in Telugu also here. Here, these, I said just now here, story of the silk. This silk we will call it as in Telugu, Chilakalu. Butterfly name to Telugu, Sita Koka Chilakalu. Silk moth matra, Chilakalu. So, she knows the name of that. Silkworm is, they will call it as a Chilakalu. Or scientific name is a Bombus mori. Okay. Here, it is just like a business. That means here, up to the silk moth, it will available in the market. Some of the people will go and buy only the silk moth. They will buy only the silk moth and they take that and they lie in the mulberry leaf so that it will lay eggs on that. Okay. After laying eggs, it will die, I say. Another group of people come and purchase these eggs, only the eggs, and they will start incubating their eggs and it will hatch out and comes larva out of that. And some other group of the people comes and buy these small tiny larvas which will comes out of the eggs, okay, and they start giving the food to that group. Some other batch of the people will come and buy these larvas and they allow for cocoon formation. And some other people and other group of people, they will come and buy these cocoons of the silkworm and they start marketing. And some other group of the people, they will come and they will start prepare the silk and they will try to sell in the market. And some other group of people, again they will go for the recycling process. Are you confused? Wait, I'll say clearly now. Eklima, it is a kind of a business. It is a kind of a business in a market. Okay. Here different people are involved in this process. Not a single person is involved. Suppose if you take the paddy harvesting field, only single people is involved in the paddy harvesting. Whereas in a story of a silk, there are different kinds of people involved, from young to the up to the adult silk moth. Young means mother world, adult work. A group of people are involved. Kontamandi eggs ni konukoni hatches. A hatch and the clutch in the small larvas will come out of that. Kontamandi chan larvan konukundas. They start growing. Kontamandi the growth caterpillar konukundas. They start processing the cocoon. Some other people come and buy the cocoon. And the various groups of people are involved in the different stages of the silk worm. But the point? Any confusion? No. Okay, shall I continue? Okay. Now comes to the story again. Okay. Here, moth to egg. Just now I said it will lay 500 eggs and it will die off. Some other people will come and purchase that eggs and they start placing in an incubator. That is comes to the second stop. That is eggs to cocoon. Here star to, which is eggs to cocoon. Okay. Here they will purchase these cocoons and they will place it in an incubator till it comes out of the larva. Larva, how it will be the larva? I said that eggs itself is small, very small, just like our mustard seeds. Think that if eggs are the very, very small seeds, that how the larva comes out of that? If it is trying just like a comma, okay? The size of the starting larvas will be just like a comma size, okay? That comes from the start to egg to cocoon, okay? Now I want to repeat this once again here. What do you mean by sericulture? Rearing of the silkworm is known teacher. Scientific name of the silkworm is Vomex mori. Okay. The eggs of the silk moth is seeds. In a story of a silk moth, it involves the four stars. In a first star, moth to egg, and second star, eggs to cocoon. How many eggs did the silkworm lay? 500 eggs. In the complete its lifespan, it will lay 500 eggs and will die. This is the story of the silk. I will continue in the next section. Stall 3 and stall 4. Thank you.